Hello everyone, I want to show you my 85mm lens. This is a Nikon 85mm 1.8G and I bought a 1.8 because I didn't need the 1.4. And by not buying the 1.4 I could save $1,000, so it's money in the pocket. It has a lens hood, which I don't use, front element. Most lenses have that F-mount bit, if they thing. Let's put it on the camera. Now what you have is a button here, autofocus, manual focus, and you have a camera that's not too it's not too big, if you know what I mean. Even this tripod collar, a tripod mounty thing, it's reasonable size, especially when you have man hands. For women, it's not too heavy. It's not if you compare it to a Sigma 85 with a D850, this is a small combination. So let's go over to the computer to check out some technical aspects, and then we are going into the images of the ladies that I shot in the past, my lady models. So let's go over. So we're at the Nikon page. This is the lens that I'm talking about, the 1.8G 85mm. They have a page full of sample images if you want to check that out, but I'm going to show you my images. Key features, it's pretty much amazing, blah blah blah. So I don't understand what it says, so I'm not even gonna bother. Most important, 85mm is a good portrait lens. Then you have a maximum aperture, the maximum opening that can that light through is 1.8. You also have a 1.4 version, which is 3 times the price, and in the quality you won't really notice it. Minimum aperture f.16, so that's a small hole bit. Now there is a lot of stuff written here about what I care about is not what it says here. What I care about is what I can do with it. So what I'm going to show you is two different types of images. First of all, I'm going to show you this is straight out of camera, a raw image through the raw converter. That's it. Lens correction, some basic things, and that's it. Well, then it goes into Photoshop. I fix it, so color, that kind of stuff, small bibbity boops bops. I can't even see what I did here, and that's a lot of stuff, and you end up something like this. So when you zoom in, this image never got said 100% got published because I can't remember why. Look at the eyes, it's all nice and sharp, nothing to complain. And if you go to, it says 300 ppi, if you go down to 72 ppi for Instagram or for a website, it's great. Okay, next one. Let's zoom in a little bit. What did I do? Took something away, and you see that's something you can't see. Oh, that's my text that I put on it. For some reason Adobe doesn't know the font. Okay, and what you get is vibrance. So when you look zoom in, you basically have an amazing image. Look at it. And this is for just a $450-$500 1.8 lens. So it's at 300 ppi, there's nothing wrong with the image. It's great. It's an amazing model, by the way. So it's my favorite model. Here's another one, straight out of camera. Did a bit of color correction. A bit of fixing. Fix the background, so that's gone. Fix a little bit more, so you see that loop. done with the liquefying tool and the color balance. And this is an image that I really like. If you do a little bit of extra work, because it's already amazing, it's at 300 ppi, and you do it at 100 ppi, you get this. And this you can find on my 200 100. You can find this one on my Instagram page, I think, so you can check it out there. Really like this image. It's one of my favorites. Okay, this one is outside. It was done while I was waiting for somebody, and I was like, yeah, nice pictures. I think I named it something like Twin Towers. It's in my home city, and it has, yeah, well, Twin Towers. Well, doesn't it? Okay, so a little bit of fixing. This is straight out of camera. This is just, I think it was raw. Okay. Do a bit of changing, because this was a bit weird with her hair and this one. And so, okay. Did this one. And I was mucking about. I don't think this one got published this way, but this was pretty much the end result. So what you see now is it looks nice. So even when you go into, let's say, 100%, there was no noise reduction, and yeah, this you can find on my Instagram page as well. This was the lady I was waiting for, and what you see is dirty street, but it's an okay picture. There's nothing wrong with it. So let's make it better. Clean it up. That looks better. I never overdo cleaning up, because we're outside, and if you make it like a laboratory environment too clean, it's just unrealistic. Bit of this, because that was a bit of a mood I was in back in the day. And it's done. So you will notice that I didn't do massive amounts of Photoshop. Great. I think it's on my Instagram as well. I can't remember. This is straight out of camera. Let's go to 100%. So you'll see. Looks nice. Well, it needs a little bit of help. So watch the changes. See? Done. What you get then, without a huge amount of Photoshop, I mean, I could fix the blotches on her skin and stuff, but look at it. She has a pretty face, by the way. I must say that she has a really pretty face. Looks nice. Looks nicer as this, but we can do better. Did not do a lot of Photoshop on it, as you can see. This is actually what I used. Don't even need Photoshop for that. First of all, this. It's all minor things. This is what you can get with a bit of Photoshop. And this lens. Look at the detail. Nice eyes. Oh man, beautiful eyes. So, great lens. This is straight out of camera. And there is a thing with this image. I think I never published it. But this is a straight out of camera shot. Put it through camera raw to, well, fix things. Camera, lens distortion, and a little bit of things. So, first fix. And now it's just vibrance and little things. So what you see here is that amazing eyes. Beautiful lady. Anyway, that was the pictures I wanted to show you. I hope you like it. like the pictures. I would like to pick up model photography again soon, but right now there is a lack of models. And without a model, it's difficult to do portrait work. The 85 mm 1.8 is a really affordable, great lens. It's a lens that is, like I said, affordable, gives you great results, but with any F-mount lens to a DSLR, it goes for Canon as well, for their, I can't remember what mount it was, but for any lens you buy for a DSLR, try to get it calibrated to your body. In this case, the 85 mm was calibrated to my D750, and then you will get great results. That's all I can say. So I hope you like the pictures I showed you. I hope you like what I had to say about it. If you have any questions about the 85 mm, please let me know and I will answer it. No affiliate links, no, it's just free information. Yeah? Okay. So let me know what you think. Please like, that will help me out. If you want to subscribe, that would help me out too with the next video. Goodbye for now. Until the next video. Bye bye.